Hey there, my name is Kristian Kohle and I'm running Kohle Keller Studio in Germany, and I've worked with quite a lot of bands in the last 20 years. Bands like Powerwolf and Aborted and Crematory and Eskimo Callboy and No Turning Back and many others. I would say extreme metal isn't extreme metal. So for example, with Aborted, I wasn't going for a total transparency. I was going for the vibe. So that wasn't too difficult to mix. But typically these days with modern extreme metal, I mean, of course, everything is all over the place. So everything is very distorted, it's super fast, goes up to 300 BPM. In one song, you have as many drum hits as on an entire rock album. So you need to take care that everything is well played, everything is super transparent, usually a lot of EQing. There's also some editing involved, of course, to just make sure everything sounds clear and clean. I think that's the most demanding thing. My relationship with Aborted has grown over time. I think when they came to my studio the first time, that was the Termination Redux EP, they were just expecting me to make their record sound great. And that's what death metal bands typically do. They go to the studio, their songs are done, they want them to be recorded and to be mixed and sound great. And I mean, I like to get creative and I have an opinion, but it always depends on the band. Some want you to chime in, others don't. Death metal bands are typically not used to that, but Aborted is a great band and I wanted to do as much as I can to make their records better. And so far we have done 4 productions together, and I think each time I was involved a little bit more, and I felt like on the latest one, TerraVision, they trusted me and accepted me, not as a part of the band, but like another opinion from the outside, giving them suggestions and stuff. It has grown into not only a working relationship, but a good friendship. We like each other, and I think you can hear that on TerraVision. There have been quite some changes. I think one thing that is obvious right now is that the whole metal scene is growing older. The scene was much younger when I was 15 compared to now, and young kids, for them, metal is not like the hippest thing at the moment. They're into hip-hop or other things, but I'm not afraid because that's gonna change. I believe one day or in a few years there will be another Jim Morrison or Marilyn Manson or Kurt Cobain or someone in rock or metal inspiring the kids to pick up a guitar and do great music that will make metal younger and fresher and more hungry again. That's what I'm waiting for. On the other hand, I have to say the metal scene perhaps 20 years ago, there were a lot more fights. You were either listening to hardcore or to power metal or to death metal. So there's a lot more tolerance these days. Like everybody is listening to everything, and that's something that I say that I enjoy. In politics, in Germany and in the US, everybody is fighting, and I believe in the metal scene, people are typically quite tolerant and open to anything from hard rock to the most extreme stuff, and that's something I really like about this scene. I think in general, the more the bands let me be a part of the creative process, the more fun it is. I don't know, I remember doing an album for a band called Agatha Damon, a black metal band, and that album was released by Nuclear Blast in, I don't know, 2002 or something. And that was the first time like a big label released something that I produced, and I'm still kind of proud of it. I think that was a band called Destinity. That was the first foreign band, a French band, coming to my studio, and I felt so important that, you know, a foreign band comes to my place. There was a Powerwolf album, Preachers of the Night, that went to the top of the German charts, to number one, and that was also something important because it helped my career a lot. But there's so many other albums I'm kind of proud of, and even if you end up not liking the sound anymore after 5 years, like remembering how awesome it was to get creative with those bands is something that will last forever.